Okay, here we are back in Monster Hunter Rise, and this time we're going up against Mizutsune, which I'm not looking forward to because he's a little tricky with the whole bow gun thing, and I probably should just capture him. Okay, let's grab that. So anyway, the hard part is I have to continuously make sure I have at least one wire bug ready in case I need to jump over his water spout attack. And now that I think about it, I'm actually going to go eat inside the tent because my armor does have a little bit of water weakness to it. Where's the... Oh, right there. It has a weird entry area. Parlor sucks. So yeah, I'll take the water resistance. That should cut into some of his breath crap. Now, if I wanted to, I could... Actually, no, I don't think you could do that at this stage. You have to beat him first. So scratch that. What I was getting at is I do have options to mitigate him a bit. Now, the thing is, I don't actually know what his symbol is. I think it's the one on the far right, with the middle one being Nargacuga. Which means we're heading straight into... Or no, is he outside? Hmm. Try not to forget Pierce ammo right here for you if you're gunning. Don't mind me. Just a figment of your imagination. Need to grab that. And here's Mizu. Now, Mizu is a leviathan. I think I mentioned this during the demo. Pierce ammo will ruin his day. More so if I get amplified by a red level. I literally jumped into it. Think you're funny, do you? Now, the other advantage to piercing is you can just shoot through the bubbles and hit him. Still hit me, wow. Pop his own attack bubble. And I'm much, much worse off from that exchange. So I may get two attacks off with the attack buff. I think we may have broke a claw or something. Rock is blocking some of my attacks there. part of the reason why I definitely need to cut off his tail is because I did not have the opportunity to do so in the demo. So I kind of need to show that it's possible and everything. Okay, whistle since the dog doesn't want to come when you push the A button. So right now, I am very vulnerable. So he has a bubble there that I'm just not going to be able to get. Like, one of my concerns with him is always, do I give priority to the bubble, or should I just keep swinging? I don't know if there's like a good way around that for I have to just vault up for that one too. Couldn't see him, so I couldn't prepare for it. But hopefully you can see just how dangerous that bubble beam is for gunners. Well, I wouldn't say a heavy gunner because you can always just do your counter move. Basically, I'm just running until he gets back in the arena. That was his grill that just popped. And if he's gonna do the stationary one, you have the opportunity to punish him with your pierce rounds, but it's not as ideal as the others. So the capture icon should be appearing any moment now. That may have been his back that just broke. But you can just see the damage numbers coming out here. He can't seriously take this for much longer. Don't really care about the Ludroth material, to be honest.
Yes!
You Yes, the icon is there.
Yes.
Actually, now that I think about it, I was going to catch this one, didn't I? I don't have a trap on me, do I? Yeah, I really didn't care about dodging that because I was more interested in trying to find the trap, which I'm not carrying. Well, that settles that. Keep in mind, I have not done the ride yet. It's possible by the time I do get the chance to do it, this could be over. So he did heal me there. And that's the smallest one I've seen to date. I am bubble-blooded right now. Yeah, I can't believe I don't have a trap. He's a lot more dangerous when he's bubble-blighted because Arzeros. As I was saying, he's a lot more dangerous when he's bubble-blighted because he's able to do his whole genocide, braver, bubble beam, whatever you want to call it, while sliding. Now, I think Mizu does have a plate, but I don't care to get it. I didn't see anything worthwhile in his stuff. So head back, Finn. Immature sponge from all the collateral damage to the loot drops. I don't think I mentioned before, but like one of the big advantages to Pierce, of course, is you can use another monster as a shield, literally shooting through them to hit something on the other side, and the monster, unless they have a Pierce thing themselves, like the Genocide Braver, they can't hit you back. Yeah, I didn't have a trap. Oh, that was embarrassing. Don't want that one. We're more likely to do this one than I am to kill 5 or 8 monsters. Let's continue our Moonlight Waltz. And hopefully this one can go a little bit smoother. Actually, cancel that one and give me the water resistance. So let's see how much they vary this time around. Doing stuff on the computer, which is why I was so quiet. I think I'm gonna lead with the slicing ammo because the way he moves. Let's see, we still got Narga. I Thing is, we don't have a really good route to reach him. I also haven't found a good way to use freeze ammo just yet. Okay, we just need a little bit more endemic life. There we go.
Yes, mazu wa hitotsu. Yoisho.
Nothing else, just that's an opportunity for my stamina to recover. Barely dodge that. That one, not so fortunate. And the timing on that was perfect. It's gonna hit me with all three, I think. Okay, I'm hoping that'll get the stupid hound's attention, but it looks like I'm just gonna have to slide in.
Oh.
Now, this one isn't always here. Either the back or maybe the first part of the head that broke. Uh-oh. Right there's the bubble blight thin line to slide all over the place. Like, the one upside of that one is I don't think it can pivot, it can only slide. Best way to probably think of it is, I don't know if you play League of Legends, but Lucian's ultimate. Can't really change the direction, but you can change your position. So if we can get on this side, we'll actually be safe. sucked. I'm not gonna try to ride it here. I would like to get the third wire bug for doing so, but still we can hammer it. Now with that much damage to its face, we can land a few more headshots we can topple it with. That's the big danger to him. I am bubble blighted here. This interacts with a heavy bowgun now that I think about it. So maybe strats involving the bubble play. So we haven't broken the head. And that would be the fully broken face. So any moment now, the capture marker should go up. Hopefully you can see that the bubbles can't do anything to me. They can just pierce away. I have to worry about the monster's actual jaws. So with this, I'm done fighting. I don't see any more shinies unless there's one hidden here. There it is. Mizu tail. Narga's directly above us. If it's gonna actually sleep, I'll let it. It looks like it spotted us. Okay, I don't know what happened there. Apparently I had a secondary quest where I needed to capture one anyway, so two birds, one stone. Or in this case, two quests, one wyvern. So I'll show off the origami thing real quick. That's going to cause a new item or something to appear. really like seeing anything of value here. And I really do mean nothing of value. The tail is the best part, which is really, really depressing. Although we did get one piece of purple for, I guess. So I don't know who it is we have to speak to actually collect on it. In case you're wondering what that was real quick. Full day inspiration. Hanamori the Guide. I think it's over here. Right there.
Oh.
There we go, we now can make the origami switch axe. And I will pull that up real quick. I think you have to get to 6 stars before you can actually take that quest, for those who are wondering. Should be all the way at the bottom, I believe, since it's a special weapon. And here you go, origami. Looks like it has a little bit of blue sharpness, not really that much. Main thing, though, is the dragon element on that sword. Need Agnosum parts, go figure. And also Almadon, but yeah. Anyway, that is it for now, folks. Mizu has bitten the dust, and next up is Narga. I'm the Hero of Light. Thanks for watching, and goodbye.